Okay. Hello.
So I'm doing my April favorites. This is like March, April, and May because, well, a little bit of May. It's March 10th. I mean May 10th. What? Oh my God. I didn't do a March. I didn't do a March favorites because I had bought a whole bunch of stuff. And although I liked a lot of the things that I bought immediately, like on contact, like literally first try, gave myself some time to get used to the product before I actually came on here and was like, ooh, I like this, you know? This is gonna be kind of long because I have a lot of stuff to talk about. So get ready, grab some popcorn, some chicken, whatever you eat when you like to watch videos, and let's get crack-a-lackin'. Do I have any apps? Do I have any apps? Digit just came out with a new app, which I'm excited about. If you guys don't know about Digit, it's how I save money. You guys should check that out as well. This is not sponsored by them or anything. I literally just wanted to plug this because, you guys, I actually use Digit on a regular basis to save and transfer savings to my checking account. The other day I had to pay a bill. I went to the doctor like in September and I was so pissed. Oh my God, I was so pissed. I was livid that I got this doctor bill 9 months later, $400. I don't have time for that. So I snuck into my Digit savings and pulled some money out, saved my bum. So you guys know in the month of March, I cut my hair off. But I really just wanted to cut it because the price was way too high, so we need to cut it. Cut it, cut it. Actually really love my hair now. Like that's actually a favorite, is my hair. I really love it. I love how easy it is. Hair update, quick hair update. It's very easy to manage, very easy to take care of. I do not experience any reverting or getting curly or things like that. The only issue I've been having is with this little back part right here because it grows back really fast and then it gets puffy when it grows back. But other than that, I don't have an issue with it. As long as I keep it cut low, it's fine. I got this curls, Blueberry Bliss Curl Control Paste from Target. And I actually really like this. I've only used a little bit of it, but I use it whenever I want to lay down this back part right here when it's not cooperating with me. When my hair gets old, I wear hats a lot. And this is the part that sticks out. So obviously I have to keep that laid. I mean, there's no way for me to hide that. And I've been obsessed with all things blueberry lately because I love blueberries. That's a favorite, that's a grocery favorite. They've made my skin so beautiful. Like, I just feel like my skin looks a million times better, and 90% of the reason is for water, but like 5% of the reason is because I eat 1,000 blueberries a day. 1,000. A few perfumes that I really, really like. My favorite for March was the Marc Jacobs Daisy Oh So Fresh Blush. Gorgeous bottle, but it actually smells really nice too. It doesn't last a long time because it's not a eau de parfum. It is a eau de toilette. But it smells really, really fresh. It's a great spring summer scent. It has a very nice florally fruity smell. Throughout March, I had a rollerball of this scent, which is Black Opium by YSL. And I loved it so much. And I'm so glad that I got a full bottle of it. It just smells like sexy woman, like bomb slayage. I love it. I love this perfume. One of my favorite perfume scents of all time, actually. I will put this up there with my Prada Candy and my Terry Mugler Alien. Okay, this is a top dog. This is Ariana Grande, and it's just so cute. Like, very flirty and playful. It's very sweet, fruity. I really like that perfume too. I mix those two sometimes when I want to be a good mix of flirty and playful and sexy and, ooh girl, what you doing tonight? So yeah, that's my two favorite fragrances for the month. I need to hurry up because the flash is coming on, so I don't know why I'm playing games. All right, so moving on to skincare. I have three skincare items that I wanna talk about. The first one being this Take the Day Off Cleansing Balm by Clinique. I've seen dupes for this, like Pixie, I think, the brand is Pixie, and I think they have one just like this, but it is $20. Pretty much the same price. At least I think this was $20. 20 or 30. Honestly, I feel like it does better than like makeup remover wipes and things like that because one, it's a lot gentler. It gets off mascara effortlessly, which I really like because I hate taking off mascara. It's literally the worst part of my night. I end up ripping out a lot of my eyelashes when I was using makeup wipes because I was like rubbing back and forth and really doing a lot. But I feel like this is a lot easier. It just slip and slides your makeup off of your face. It rinses off clean. It doesn't leave an oily feeling because if you use an oil on your face, it leaves your face oily afterwards, which I don't like because then I have to work harder when I wash my face to get the oils off to cleanse it, you know? So I mentioned this in my skincare video, which if you haven't seen it, you should check it out. I recommend it. I would say try it. And I like the luxuriousness of using a balm to take off your makeup as opposed to just using a wipe, you know? Get your hands in there, get dirty. This is another favorite. Now this is it's a little pricey, okay? It's a little pricey. This is the Tatcha Polished Classic Rice Enzyme Powder. It has got like some really like expensive ingredients. I'm pretty sure it has crushed pearl in it, which I mean, a pearl, like, are you kidding me? Crushed pearls, like, how much more luxurious can you get? Cleanses the skin really well. I was reading online and it says that it's good for people who have dark spots and things like that because it's brightening. It's good for normal to combination oily skin. It's very exfoliating, but it's not harsh. So I feel like people who have acne or really sensitive skin can use this and it won't hurt their skin at all because it isn't abrasive. It's like, if you can see, it's got like that powderiness. It looks like cocaine, don't be alarmed. You just pour it in your hand, you put a little water in there, I sprinkle a little water in there to make it like kind of like a lather or whatever, and it really gets your skin like super, super clean. So if you wanna try it out, I suggest you should try it out. You should go to Sephora, get a sample. It's a lot, and I was actually considering buying this with my money, but Tatcha sent it to me. Thank you, Tatcha, I really appreciate it. I have bought Tatcha products before and I know that they're expensive, but I feel like they're worth the money. Even if you don't want to spend the money on it, go to Sephora, get you a sample. They will give you a free sample and you can just keep restocking on samples as much as you want. And then the last skincare favorite is this scrub, which I love Soap and Glory. My mom put me on because it makes her skin super soft and my skin has just been immaculate because I've been using this and the Righteous Butter. I've already talked about the Righteous Butter before, and Righteous Butter is scent from heaven. Exfoliating your skin is really good. So I've been exfoliating my body a lot too because I have dark spots on my body. Like, I don't just get them on my face. I get them all over my body, okay? Do you see how much is left in here? I bought this 2 weeks ago. Just look at it. Look how much I've used. That's how you know. That's how you know. Shea butter, sugar, and peach seed powder spa body polish with skin smoothing sea salt, grape seed, and almond oil. Get your hands on it before they sell out because they're always sold out of Soap and Glory. Palettes that I've been ranting and raving about. If you've been watching my makeup tutorials or anything where I talk about makeup, you know that these are like all of my faves right now. So I'm just gonna go through the list. I'm not gonna talk about the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. And I'm just gonna let you know, I don't use it on a day-to-day basis, so it's not a favorite. It's just a favorite. This is a favorite. This is Tartlet in Bloom palette. And if I hit this earring one more time, I'm gonna punch myself in the face. But this is an amazing palette. Palettes are not cheap, okay? They're like 40, 50 bucks, depending on what brand it is. This one was 50, I think, but it's worth it. Oh my God, it's worth it. Everybody who said anything nice about this palette, thank you, because you weren't lying. I love that this smells like chocolate. Point number two, super pigmented. Point number three, neutrals. All day, every day. Got a reddish neutral, got a reddish brown neutral. You know, your light browns, your dark browns, your creams, you got some golds in there. Like, how could you not use this palette? Please explain to me. I use it almost every day that I wear eyeshadow. Anytime that I wear eyeshadow, I use this palette. Except for this look today. I try not to use it, but I really wanted to. But yeah, it's just a great palette. It's pretty. Look at the packaging, oh my goodness. It's just, Only thing I don't like about it is it does have a lot of fallout. I'm pretty heavy-handed with the brush, okay? So me picking up product and slapping it on my face, I do tend to make a mess. Other two palettes, of course, we're gonna talk about these because these were Maybelline. These are probably gonna be favorites for the whole summer, all summer 16. These are the Anastasia Glow Kits. Now, of course, I got both because I'm a makeup junkie. And I needed to try both to let you guys know how they work for darker skin tones, because everybody says this one is not good for darker skin tones, but they lied to you. It does work. Now, the only reason I said this works is because I feel like I can wear gold and silver. If you feel like you can't wear silver, you won't like this because it is like all silver and rose colored highlighters. I, on the other hand, do find that I can use this when I'm wearing silver jewelry. When I'm wearing gold jewelry, I like to wear this one. This one has more gold tones and it's got a darker one in here too for the darker ladies. You know, if you got that chocolatey mocha skin, you know, melanin on fleek, you could rock this with ease. I find that if you use a light hand, it doesn't come off too ashy, so I like both of them. But depending on what colors you like to rock, that would let you know which one to get. They're 40 bucks, but I feel like it's worth the money only because you get four different colors. So it's like you get one for $10 each. They're about the size of like a Becca highlighter or blush. So you're getting a really good deal, I feel like. Since I picked that up, I might as well talk about it. These are the Becca Luminous Blushes. These just came out not too long ago. This is Snapdragon and Tiger Lily. Tiger Lily is an orangey color with gold flecks in it. This one is Snapdragon. Let me show you. Rosy corally color. And I like to mix these because it gives me the perfect corally orange for the summertime. I think they're beautiful. I have on Tiger Lily today. I believe they're $30, which is a little pricey for a blush, of course, because it's Becca. But like I've said before about Becca, all Becca products are great. I haven't experienced any negative, nothing with Becca. I love Becca. I did a girl's makeup the other day and she's very light. She's fair skinned. They look good on her too. So very good for different skin tones. I love that Becca products work well for a lot of different skin tones. They just kill it. They kill the game with that for me. I have two bronzers that I love. You guys have seen them a million times because I've used them a million times. This Hoola bronzer, which I thought was not gonna work for me, but it did. And I was so pleasantly surprised. It's good for contouring for me, I feel like, because it's not too dark and it's not too harsh. And I already have a very chiseled, sharp, angular face. So I don't need a lot of contouring. And I feel like this is perfect for me because it's a very good medium toned. It's cool toned, it's not warm. This is ColourPop's K-Pop Bronze Me bronzer. Almost hit pan on this one. Like it's coming. I can feel it. Look how much I've used. And I feel like it would work on a lot of different skin tones. It's just, ooh. All of the Karrueche stuff is bomb. Including this Chi Ultra Matte Lippy. This is one of my favorite. I've been wearing this a lot for the past 2 months. It's a good nude. Like with the right lip liner. And I love the lip liner too. Where is it at? Speaking of ColourPop, I've been loving all of ColourPop's cream, gel, liners, and pots. I use this one today for my eyes. This is a yellow color, and then this is like a lavender color that I used in my candy color liner tutorial. And I used the eye pencils. This one's Zulu, Prance, Puppy, Boots, Punch. I've used all of these. My only gripe about these products, the stick on the inside does break easily. It comes out easily. But I mean, these are only like $5, so I mean, you get what you pay for. But I love the pigmentation. I feel like they're very creamy. They're perfect for the waterline, especially if you have sensitive eyes or you feel like putting on eyeliner on the waterline doesn't stay. I've worn these and they did not budge even through my crying and my emotionalness. And the pots, my only issue with the pots is that this one was really like hard to put on. So what I would suggest is getting like Inglot Duraline or something that'll like emulsify the product and make it a little more creamy because it is like hard. Color payoff is amazing. Stays all day, doesn't move. So you guys should try them out. I was gonna talk about my Becca foundation, but I just made a whole review on it. So you guys should check out my full review. I'm not gonna talk about that in this video. I've really been loving Gleam by Melanie Mills. This is the body radiance. And I have the colors deep gold and rose gold. I use deep gold on my body, like on my legs. And I use rose gold on my face mixed with my foundation to make my skin look super glowy. And I feel like it kind of helps my makeup stay on good too, which is a plus. And this is perfect for your legs, like if you want that sheen, like if you want the shine, but you don't want to be slick and oily. And it doesn't come off on your clothes after it's set. Let it set first, because if not, it's gonna get everywhere. But this is basically like self-tanner. I like it. It's Vicky approved. And this is Glossier's Priming Moisturizer Buildable Hydrating Cream. It's like a moisturizer, but it also doesn't make me like super greasy or anything to where my foundation doesn't stay on. It actually helps my foundation stay on a lot better. And you guys know I like to put on a good moisturizer and a good primer before I do my makeup. Helps for my skin to feel good under my makeup, because if I'm dry, I get itchy and I get irritated. But then my face is like, ooh, you're dry, so it gets more oily. So I just feel like it helps to neutralize my skin and make it like the perfect canvas for my makeup. This is Laura Mercier's setting powder in translucent. A lot of people have been asking me what I think about this compared to my Sasha Buttercup powder. I like the way it sets a lot better than the Sasha powder, but I like the Sasha powder for the yellowness, because this can look a little ashy on its own, which is why I've been mixing them and you guys are asking why I use both. This why. But this is an amazing powder. I would use it by itself. I'm heavy-handed with the powder. Like I said, I'm heavy-handed with the brush. So I pack on a lot and I don't want it to look too ashy. And then last, what I'm going to talk about is this random gloss that I got from Marc Jacobs. I got it from Sephora, but it's a Marc Jacobs Pink Flamingo Enamored High Shine Lip Lacquer. Ever since I started wearing this, everybody's been asking me what gloss I've been wearing, and this is it, guys. It is so good. Like, it's very shiny, but it's not sticky. Real quick. These are my superstars, my Adidas superstars. I wear these all the time. I really like them. I just feel like they're the perfect summer sneaker. I don't know, they just go with everything and they're super comfy. Like, I bought them to be cute and fashionable, but they're actually super comfy. Like, there's a reason why all the bloggers wear these, because they're super comfy. Those are my favorites. Babe?
Yeah?
Are you ready? Come on down. You guys, Cameron has favorites that he wants to show you guys.
Hey, so let's get started with some of my favorites. I don't have monthly favorites, but I do have favorites that exist. Stay with me. First, I want to start off with the fragrance. Polo Red.
Do you want me to?
Intense. Go ahead, Banna Black. It smells really good.
Oh, no. No. You can come back. I have on a Tori Kelly t-shirt because I just went to her concert on Friday. And you guys know how I feel about Tori. We're friends. We're best friends, obviously. What kind of best friend are you if you don't wear your friend's merch? Come on. This ring is from H&M. This is a Daniel Wellington watch, and I do have a coupon code for it. It is Vicky Lou, which is my old YouTube name. You get 15% off. So yeah, check it out. It's actually a really pretty watch. It's rose gold, and it's got these diamonds on it. And then this bracelet is by my friend DK.
That's crazy.
Oh, did you bring yours too? Your arm candies? Aw. Show them yours, babe. I put his information in the description box, but he made us these like handmade bracelets.
So mine is like blue and gold. Then he made me this lava rock one, which is pretty dope too. And then
it looks like those rocks that you shoot out on spiral.
This is my first one that he made me. It's just, you know, normal one. You just boom. Before the camera cut off, I was talking about the Polo Red Intense summer spring scent, and she loves it, so it's a win-win for me.
50 Shades of Red.
An inexpensive fragrance is the Zara Musk for a Perfect Walk. This joint smells so good, and it was $12, man. I got my Burberry London. This smells really good, too.
Do I like this one?
This is that grown and sexy, you know what I'm saying? When you want to put on a three-piece. You know, I want to put your suit on, put on a power tie.
That's when you got on a suit. You wear that when you got on a suit, don't you?
Yep, I just said that.
Oh.
I'm a sneakerhead. I love shoes. It's a blessing and a curse. The Adidas Ultra Boost. Why have these become my favorites? These are the most comfortable shoes I have ever worn in my entire 25 years of existence. First, this shoe was hyped because Kanye wears them, but it's so comfortable, like it's ridiculous. You want to try these on and your life will instantly change.
Adidas does have some really good shoes out right now.
They've
been killing it right now.
Listen, I've been a Nike Jordan kid my whole life, but Adidas is killing the lifestyle shoe game right now.
They really are.
It's insane. I was going to show you all some of my tubulars and my dooms or whatever. But y'all not ready for that yet. The Vans, bro.
Dang, Daniel.
Slowly becoming obsessed. Because I'm thinking about Steph Curry winning MVP. Shout out to him. I'm slowly becoming obsessed with monochromatic shoe colors.
Yeah.
Vans, if y'all want to send me a lifetime supply, go ahead. Other shoes that aren't noted. The Steph Curry 2s. Any color you get, they're really comfortable. Lock your heel down. Traction is great. Super lightweight for a mid-top shoe. Exceptional. And the Kobe 11. The shoe is unbelievable. It's beautiful. The traction is good. The cushioning is good.
The traction.
God is Dope t-shirt. Get the God is Dope. And I got some more stuff coming in.
You don't have any makeup favorites? Any skincare favorites?
My makeup favorites. I love when she does the smoky eye. So whatever products are involved in that. I like this look too. I like when she does kind of like the Hunger Games, you know, 75th quarter quest. And I love my Impact t-shirts. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead and get these.
Where?
Go ahead and get these.
Where?
If you need them, holla at your boy. You know what I'm saying?
That's all for this video. So, yeah, like this video. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up. Let me know if you want to see more videos, more favorites videos. If you want to see more of this guy and his favorites, let me know. And we can arrange that. We can make that happen. I will talk to you guys in my next video. I love you, and I'll see you guys later. Peace out.